Funding and moral support for this broadcast is brought to you by the Rodriguez Foundation and from viewers like you. Thank you.
Hey, VC. This spotlight's going to be about Reid Miles, the graphic designer and art director for Blue Note Records. Everyone knows Reid Miles' work for the Blue Note label. You'd know it if you'd see it. His work during that time is legendary. His use of Francis Wolff's photography, his spacing, his layout, typography, his constant inventiveness, all of it just really works together to bring this whole complete package and really show what the record will sound like.
By the 1960s, Reid became more and more adventurous in how he'd use typography, sometimes omitting photos altogether. This is Joe Henderson's 1964 album, In and Out. A tiny crop of a photo of Henderson plays a supporting role to a bold and energetic design, with those arrows driving the feeling of the album's title home.
There's a Jackie McLean album called It's Time.
There's that tiny crop of a photo again.
And then just exclamation points for the rest of this cover. Black type on white. And it's just startlingly beautiful and startlingly getting your attention.
And the music inside is really reflective. And when you put it on, you feel the urgency, you feel the movement of the record itself. And when you look at the cover, it just seems to work so well.
What people don't realize today is that the difference between 78s and LPs is cover art. You make a 78, you put it in a brown envelope, and boom, you have a record. Once you come to the LP era, even the 10-inch LP era with three or four songs on a side, not only do you have more recording costs, but even if you're reissuing stuff that you already own, suddenly you have art costs. You have to create a front cover, write liner notes, create a back cover, and it became a far more expensive business to be in.
In the 1950s, Reid Miles worked for Esquire magazine. And then he was brought in 1955 by Francis Wolff to do the art direction and layout and graphic design for Blue Note Records. The thing about Reid Miles is that he was not a big fan of jazz, so he would often take his promotional copies that he got from Alfred and from Francis and go trade them in for classical music. He was a classical music lover. So, there's probably lots of promotional copies out there that were Reid Miles originals, made for him and made by him and then given to him, and then he trades them in for classical music. He eventually leaves when Alfred Lion leaves in 1967, and he moves to California and opens up his own company called Reid Miles Inc. He does some other layouts that are very Norman Rockwell-esque, and he eventually does some different album covers for other bands, Chicago, I believe, and he does the Basement Tapes, Bob Dylan Basement Tapes. But really his work in the 50s to the 60s for Blue Note is his most recognizable work. People know that that's Reid Miles.
Some of my favorite Blue Note covers are the ones where Reid uses Wolff's photography as a playground for typography.
If you look at the contact sheet of Una Más, the upper right-hand shot is the one that Reid Miles focused on. That would probably be one of the least memorable images on the contact sheet to me.
But Reid chose this image and perfectly placed the title of the album right in Kenny Dorham's hand. He did this with Freddie Roach's Good Move and fit Our Man in Paris around Dexter Gordon's cigarette.
What always amazed me about art directors was the ones that could create a look for a record that was highly individual, but also that fit into a stream that gave the label a look. Reid Miles was a master at that.
And then you can see his work, people trying to mimic and imitate his work for the other labels, but they don't come nearly as close and as beautiful as Reed Miles' work for Blue Note.
You just look at it today and you know it's a Blue Note record. Graphically, it permeated the entire culture. I was watching Jimmy Fallon last night, it's a late night with Jimmy Fallon, and it looks like a Blue Note cover. It's just part of the graphic vocabulary, but it was startlingly new when Reed Miles did it.
But that is all I really have for Reed Miles. Just an amazing graphic designer and art director. If you like this episode, please subscribe, comment below, like the video, all those things. Thank you so much for watching, and see you later, VC.